Hello, this is Paul from Math Department in Foresight Tech. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use the Excel to do apportionment. And there are four, three classic apportionment methods in the history: Hamilton's method, Jefferson's method, and the Webster method. The hint note here is the current method I'm not going to introduce today. So let's go back to Hamilton's method. Here are the questions. We have 75 representatives need to apportion or distribute to these five counties based on the population of each county that we look at the end. So here is the final apportionment. That means three representatives need to go to Bristol, and 12 for Kent, and 9 for Washington, and so on. Together is 75 total representatives. Okay, so how do you do this job? We need to go back to the beginning. So let's delete all these results, delete all this, delete this, and delete this, and delete this. Okay, so now is the beginning of the questions. 75 representatives need to apportioned to these five counties based on the population. And the yellow one is the first step we call the initial apportionment. The green one is the final apportionment. We need the two steps. We're going to step by step. The first step, we need to find the total population. To put the total number to this box, add all these numbers together, put it to here. How do you do? Go to the menu, home, find the auto sum, click here. It's already, this is the total population. And then we're going to find the standard divisor. So we're going to put the standard divisor here. And then end. We put the type end, put that type equal. Then click the total population, and then divided by the total representatives. Okay, to this simple calculation, and then end. So we get the standard divisor. This is about 14,000. What does this mean? This means each representative need to work with about 14,000 people. Okay, we say the workload for each representative. And another step, then we're going to find the standard quota. Standard quota, how do you find? And let's go down. Okay, left click, select these five box. We need to input the data here, and then put it equal. And then select these five box, the population, divided by 75, click, divided by, divided by the standard divisor. The population divided by the divisor, we get the standard quota, okay? And click three keys in your keyboard at the same time. Control, Shift, and Ent, okay? Control, Shift, and Ent. So we get the standard quota. What does this mean? This means 3.55 representatives need to apportion to Bristol. That's the decimal people. Impossible, right? Okay, so we need to get the initial apportionment. That's not a decimal. So how to find it? Hamilton's method is going to log down, going to get it down. So like 3.55 goes to 3, 11.8 goes to 11. So how do you do this? Log down, the lower quarter. The equal first, int function. This means the integer, parenthesis, click, and then parenthesis, then int. Okay, so we get three. This is the lower quota from Hamilton's method. And then you look at it, the function is int. We copy these books to all these five counties. How do you copy? So first click here, three. The box, and then move your mouse to the right bottom, and then you will find a black cross. And then left click, draw down. Okay, so did the carpet. This is the initial apportionment. Let's look at how many needs total. Okay, select all these, go to home, auto sum, 72. Means what? And the first step, initial apportionment, we apportion 72 representatives, but we have 75, so there are three left. And Hamilton's method to apportion the extra three to these five countings, how to, based on the decimal number. Okay, so we look at the first decimal number, the biggest one is 0.9. So here the decimal is 0.8, here the decimal is 0.5, go on. So the biggest decimal number here. Okay, so we assign these extra one representative first one. Then we look at the second biggest decimal, 0.8, right? So assign another representatives. We have three, so another 3.5, here, 0.6. The third largest decimal they cut. Okay, we assign one here. Okay, so these are the three extra. Okay, of course, added the three extra to each county, so we get the final. So now we have to add this column and this column to get the final apportionment. So like add this and this number together, we get this final, put it equal. And click the three, and then type plus, and then click. Okay, these two boxes add together, put here, and then enter. And now you get this the final apportionment for Bristol. The same for you are going to just copy, right? So here, nothing there means zero, don't worry. And we copy. So click the box, move the crawl, move the mouse, click to the right button, and draw down, left click and draw down. Okay, so this is the apportionment. So let's look at the total. So select all this, go to here, I'll put it the number. Go to home and auto sum, left click, 75. Done. This is the Hamilton's method. So let's go to Jefferson's method. Okay, so here's Jefferson's method. It is already the results. We'll look at it. This first step are totally the same, the yellow one, initial apportionment. The second step, the green one, we call the modified step. Okay, so this is the final, is totally different from Hamilton's method. We call the modified divider. And the original standard divider, and we need to go to modified divider. So I will going to show you later. So let's delete all these results. I'm going to show a little bit. I don't need this. I did something wrong. Right, it says I cannot see Jefferson's method. Okay, so let's delete this. Okay, delete all this. Delete. Okay, this is the beginning of Jefferson's method. Okay, 75 distribute. So the first is the same. Okay, the yellow one is the same. We're going to find the total. Select all these. Going to home. Find the total population. The same population. Then find the standard quota is the same. Okay, the workload. Remember, the total population divided by total representative means each representative need to work with how many people. And still 14,000. Then we're going to the standard quota, still same. Select this 5, double end, equal, and then use the population divided by standard divider. And then we look at the control, shift, and end. Three key at the same time, control, shift, and end. Okay, so we get it. Yeah. So how to find the initial? So the initial is the same, the inter function, remember the lowdown. They are called the lower quota. The lower quota is lowdown. Okay, so get the type equal and then type int function again, parentheses, click, then parentheses again. This is going to get the lower quota. Okay, and to get 3. So here should be 11, right? You copy. Click here, you move the right button, left click, and then draw down. See, you get a copy. Look at the total. The code home, the auto sum, the total is 72. Means we still have three representatives need to assign, right? And Jefferson's method is to modify the divider. So how to modify? Divider means the workload for each representative. So think about it here clearly. So do you need to increase the workload or decrease the workload? So we have more people left, right? It means each representative don't need to work with so many people. So we'll get this done. So I'll down to this. So let's look at. Okay, so if I change the standard divisor, go down to here. Okay, so the final step is going to get the quota again. How to get a quota? Equal. Select the population divided by this divisor is at here. Okay, click. And there's three keys at the same time. Control, Shift, and Enter. See, we get the modified the quota. And from the modified quota, get the final is the lower quota. So get the lower down. So put equal int integer function, and then lower down this, and then parentheses. And okay, we're going to copy. So move here is a black cross. Left click, draw down. Okay, then look at the total. Select all these, go to home, all the sum. 72 means what? Do you have many more representatives? Load down this again. Okay, let's get this down. Get the workload down. So I will go into this. 13, I'm going to 500. So you can try. This we call the trial and the error. Okay. And then click anywhere. So you look at all these, it all changed automatically. So because we have a formula, okay, so that's why. So we need this type of formula. So now look at 76. No, we don't have so many representatives. Means what? We need to increase the workload for each representative. Increase to 800. Oh, no matter. So and yes, go. Or if you increase to just 7, so we look at it's the other same. Don't worry. Different modified divisor will get the same final apportionment. That's normal. This is the Jefferson's method. Okay, to modify the workload or divider. So the last, let's go to Webster method, and almost the same with Jefferson's method. The idea is so they have to modify the workload or divider. And the only difference, let me go into Webster. The only difference is how to get the initial or the final here. How to get the quota is the round quota, RQ, round quota, normal round. It's not a round down, like INT. Here we use round functions to normal round. Okay, so let's go to the beginning. And we're going to show you how to do. And I did it all this result. There you know. So you look at this, the beginning of the questions. Again, we're going to get the total population. And get standard divider. Get the total population divided by total representatives. The workload for each representative. And then we get the standard quota. Okay. Select the equal the population divide the standard divisor. Three keys, control, shift, and int together. Okay, so we get. And then here is totally different. Now we will not to use int, but they use round functions. Round this number to the integer means comma. 0 means 0 decimal, right? So you can imagine parentheses again. What the results we will get? We get the 3.55, where round the normal round is 4 because no decimal, okay? So that's going to, and that's 4. So these were going to 12. These number going to 6, right? But you can copy the round function. Okay. Don't forget this 0 decimal. So going to the right button, then left click drop down. So we get we get all this initial apportionment. Let's look at the total. And go to auto sum, 76. No, we don't have 76 representative. So we have to increase the workload for each representative. Get this number bigger. How to? Try. So 1, 4, like 500. Let's try this. Okay, and use this divisor, we're going to get the quota. Put ankle. Use the population divided by the divisor. Now it's the modified divisor. 3 keys. Control, Shift, and so again, so that's going to look at the round, normal round. This to 0 decimal places and see round down. So of course, and then copy. And then we look at the total again. No. So 72 means we have more representative. So each representative don't need to work with so many people. Get this done. And I go to 4. Try. Oh, good. I go to 3 again. No, I go to 2. Try. Yeah, very good. So we already done. This is the final apportionment for Webster's method. I hope you enjoy. Bye.